हेलो हेलो, माइक टेस्ट। दिस म्यूचुअल फंड हैज़ परफॉर्म बेटर इन द मंथ ऑफ मे, जून, जुलाई, अगस्त एंड सेप्टेम्बर। इट हैज़ गिवन बेटर रिटर्न्स एज कम्पेयर टू द अदर मंथ्स। सो यस, दिस इज द वेरी यूजर फ्रेंडली डैशबोर्ड दैट वी हैव क्रिएटेड। इफ वी चेंज द नंबर ऑफ सिमुलेशंस एंड द नंबर ऑफ प्रोजेक्टेड डेज, it will update the results accordingly. Now we have a different plot and the different expected final NAV, the minimum price and the maximum price of Nippon India Small Cap Fund. Hello financial programmers, I'm Ritvik Dashora and I'm back with a new video and some new learnings. This is the third video of this playlist where we are doing detailed analysis on mutual fund schemes in India. And I'm using this tool which is called MF Tool. It's a Python library and I'm using this library to extract all the important information about mutual funds based out of India and do some sort of analysis using it. The first video was to explore the API. The second video was to build a dashboard of mutual funds in India. So these are the things that we discussed in the last video. We talked about the scheme details where we just click and say search Nippon Small Cap. We'll get all the information about scheme details related information about Nippon Small Cap. We did it for historical NAV. We did some comparison of NAVs as well. And we saw how to do average AUM. In the beginning, we explored something called view available schemes, where we just provided a keyword, for example, ICICI, and we got all the available scheme with that particular keyword. If I do it, say banking, it will give me all banking related mutual funds in India. Perfect. In the last video, if you remember, I skimmed through the code of performance heat map and risk and volatility analysis. And I've got some messages and some comments on that video that I should be making another video to explain these two things as well. So yeah, that's what I'm doing in this video. I'll be talking about the performance heat map and risk and volatility analysis of mutual funds in India. But before that, guys, if you're new to my YouTube channel, on this channel, I turn all my viewers to successful financial programmers. Here, I upload videos related to making trading bots, implementation of AI in finance, using some highly valuable finance APIs, making some great trading strategies, etc., etc. So if this is something interesting, then click on the subscribe button and also hit on the bell icon, because there are many more videos that are about to come on this YouTube channel, and I bet you that this one free click is going to increase your skill sets significantly. Perfect. So yeah, this is the dashboard that we have created using Streamlit Python library, and this is the code that we wrote in the last video. If you remember, just to quickly skim it, we are using the library called MF Tool. We are using Streamlit, Pandas, NumPy, and plotly.express for plotting purpose. In the beginning, we printed the title. We have provided a lot of options on the sidebar. We are extracting scheme names using a for loop, and then in the end we have different things for different options which are selected on the sidebar, right? Be it view available schemes, scheme details, historical NAV, comparison NAV, and average AUM. Now the next two things are performance heat map and risk and volatility analysis. So this is the first thing that I'll do. I have provided two different inputs on the sidebar as well, which are performance heat map and risk and ratio analysis, risk and volatility analysis. Let's just save it. If you come back to the dashboard, we will see that we have these two options available now. As of now, we won't have any information over here, because anyways, like, we have not provided anything in these two options. If you are struggling to use Streamlit, guys, I have made multiple videos on how to use Streamlit. Please check out those videos. It is a very good and easy to use web application tool that you guys can actually use to make some sort of dashboards, screeners, or other things as well. Please check out my last videos as well. These two options are now inserted. Now I'll just go to the end. The first one is if option is equal to, just copy this and paste it here, and we'll write performance heat map here. The first thing is st.header performance heat map. Now, similar to what we did earlier, we are getting the scheme code using this particular function. NAV data is equal to, I'll just copy the historical NAV line from here and paste it here. Control S to save it. If not NAV data dot empty, then I'll reset the index and rename it to date, because if you remember, and the NAV data and the information that we get using this particular function, which is get scheme historical NAV, we get date as one of the column. So we are renaming the column header as date. Now I'm inserting one more column, which is month, which is data dot date time index, and then I'm extracting month value from the date. Then NAV is an object format, so I have to convert it into float format, which is basically the decimal format. So let's see what is the table as of now. So I'll just do st.write, and we'll write NAV data. Let's save it. Come back here. I'll go to the historical performance, performance heat map, and select a scheme, say Nippon Small Cap. Cool. So we have this data frame now. We have date as one of the column. NAV, it's in float, which is basically decimal format. It's not in object format anymore. The day change and the month, right? So as we can see, we have now carved out the month number and made another column out of it. So now what I'm interested in is basically to do average of this day change and group by with month. I want to understand which month is actually making more return than the other month. So I'll do the same thing here. Let me just comment it, comment this particular line. So I'm writing heat map data is equal to NAV data dot group by with month of day change, and I'm taking a mean of it and resetting the index again. Now I'm inserting another column into the heat map data frame, which is month, and I'm actually providing it as string, which will be beneficial when we plot it. It should be in string. Lastly, fig is equal to px, which is the library that we imported here, which is plotly.express.density heat map. We are providing the heat map data data frame over here. The x is month, y is day change, and the title is NAV performance heat map. Lastly, we are just using st.plotlychart and providing fig inside it. The second thing is, if this is not the case, if NAV data is empty, then we'll just write that no historical data is available for this particular scheme. Let me just save it. Let's come back here and run. Perfect. It is loading. Perfect. So you can see that on the y-axis we have the day change, on the x-axis we have all the months, and you can see that as I mentioned in the last video as well, we can see that this mutual fund has performed better in the month of May, June, July, August, and September. It has given better returns as compared to the other months in any year. If I do it to some other mutual funds like Axis Blue Chip Direct Growth, again, we have similar thing, only the fund has performed better in the month of May, June, July, August, and September than the other months. This might be a coincidence, as I mentioned in the last video as well. Please do check for other mutual funds as well before making any conclusion. So that's one thing. Moving to the second one, which is risk and volatility analysis. Learning Python for finance or learning Python for financial programming is a bit challenging task, and that's the main reason I have already launched one course just made for you guys, which is basically Python for financial programming. Python is a huge language, right? And you don't need to learn everything. Less than 1% of the things available in Python would make you a financial programming expert. And that's the reason I launched this particular course, which covers that particular 1%. Just go to your browser, write fpritvik.com/python and select one of these buttons. Over here, it will you'll be redirected to the course page. If you scroll down, you will get all the information about this particular course. There are 5 sessions, 22 videos, 10 chapters, 3 assignments, 2 live projects, which are on stock analysis and investment portfolio creation. This is the detail about the syllabus. So just make sure you enroll in the course, because there are many more things that you will learn on that platform. Perfect. Let's come back to our code. The second segment is, if option is equal to risk and volatility analysis, then in that case, first 4 things are similar, which is header. We have a header of risk and volatility analysis, scheme name, which we have done here as well. Yeah, you can get it here. Scheme code, which is extracted from scheme name, and NAV information, which is basically the historical data. Perfect. Similar to the last one, if not NAV data dot empty, then in that case we are resetting the index and naming it as date. Now, as we did in the last one, we have actually provided month as one of the column. In this case, we are doing date and extracting the date information here from the NAV data. Then we are converting the NAV to numeric, as we did in the last case. We have done it using this function. In this case, we are doing it using this one. We are dropping any NA values in mid if there are. Then yeah, we are calculating the returns. So we have inserted another column, which is called returns, and the basic calculation is NAV value divided by NAV value dot shift minus 1, which is basically the last NAV value, and then in the end minus 1 to calculate the return. This will be in the decimal format. We are dropping NAs in this particular column as well, if there are any. Now let's calculate volatility. Simple. Annualized volatility is equal to NAV data and returns dot STD, which is standard deviation. Then I'm actually multiplying it with square root of 252. Now what it is? It is basically the formula to convert the daily standard deviation to annual standard deviation, which is basically done by multiplying the daily standard deviation with the square root of all the trading days in a year, which is 252, square root of 252. Similar to that, we are calculating the annualized return, which is simple, 1 plus the daily return dot mean to the power of 252, right? We are compounding it and then minus 1. Simple compounding formula. Now let's calculate the Sharpe ratio. Now for the Sharpe ratio, we need risk-free rate. So let's consider risk-free rate of 6%. In decimal format, it's 0.06, which is close to the Indian Treasury yield. Sharpe ratio is simple. We have already done it in the past. And I think if you have enrolled in my course, I have done a very detailed analysis on Sharpe ratio in the stock analysis session. So yeah, if you've already enrolled, you would learn it in much detail. But in this case, we are just calculating it using annualized return minus risk-free rate divided by annualized volatility. Lastly, we are writing all these things on the dashboard. st.write metrics for scheme name, st.metric annualized volatility, this is the one with two decimal points and a percent format. Annualized return is provided like this and Sharpe ratio. Let me just save it and let's come back to the dashboard. If you click here on the risk and volatility analysis, you will see some of the metrics which we have calculated. Risk and volatility analysis, the header metrics for Nippon's India small cap growth plan, growth option. Annualized volatility is this, annualized return is this, Sharpe ratio is good, which is more than one. Now let's do one thing. I would like to make something interactive here. So let's come back to our code. Let's make a scattered plot here. So what I'm doing here is I'm using PX, which is the same library for plotting, dot scatter. Over here, I'm providing the NAV data. X axis is date, Y axis is return. Title is risk, return, scatter for scheme name. Labels are returns, daily return, date is date. Let me just save it and come back here. I'll click on rerun. It will show me a scattered chart of the returns, daily returns for Nippon small cap in last 15 years. I can see that it's a bit more inclined towards positive direction, and there was a significant volatility at the time of COVID. If you can see, many dots are way below and way above the average level. Now I will do something very interesting. I would like to do some prediction here using Monte Carlo simulation. If you remember, I made a video on Monte Carlo simulation, I think 2 to 3 years ago. So if you'd like to understand the Monte Carlo simulation analysis in much detail, please watch that video. I'll be referring it in this video as well. The link is in the description section. Perfect. So st.write Monte Carlo simulation for future NAV projection. So the first thing required is a slider for the number of simulations and the projection period in number of days. So what I'm doing is number of simulations is equal to st.slider. Number of simulations providing the minimum value to 100, maximum to 5000, and the selected value to be 1000. Number of days starting from 30 goes to 365. The value that I'm providing as default is 252. If I save it and come back here, it will give me a slider here like this. I can actually slide it like this. And this one is like this one. I'll just write Monte Carlo simulation here. From here, I'm doing the Monte Carlo simulation analysis. Cool. Perfect. So the last NAV is the NAV that we are getting from using the iLock functionality, iLock and then minus one. Daily volatility is NAV data returns dot standard deviation. We have done it to calculate the annualized volatility as well. And the daily return is returns dot mean. So other things are, I'm starting with an empty list, which is simulation results. I'm making a for loop here for the range of number of simulations, which is by default 1000. What we are doing is we are providing the last NAV as a list for the prices. Then we are making one more for loop with number of days, which is the second slider. And then simulated return is equal to NP, which is NumPy dot random dot normal, which is basically the normal distribution. Return and volatility are the inputs for this thing. Then prices dot append, we're taking the last price multiplied by 1 plus simulated return, which is actually random using the normal distribution that we are doing here. Simulated results, simulation results dot append, and then we are appending the price in that particular list. What else? We are creating a data frame here, which is simulation df is equal to pd dot data frame, and then we are providing simulation results here, transposing it using dot t, providing the index name to be day, and then changing the columns with the number of simulations that we are doing using a simple for loop. In the end, we are plotting these simulations, right? So fig underscore simulation is equal to px dot line. It will be a line chart. What are the things which are provided? Simulation df, title would be Monte Carlo simulation for that particular scheme, NAV projection, labels are these, which are projected NAV and day. And let's just keep the template to be plotly dark. We are plotting it on Streamlit using st.plotly chart as we did before as well. In the end, we are making a summary. Final prices is equal to simulation df.iloc minus 1, which is the last price of that particular data frame. And in the end, we are writing all these things on the dashboard. The summary for this particular scheme name, expected NAV to be mean of all the final prices, minimum final NAV based on the Monte Carlo simulation and the mean and standard deviation that we provided. It should be final price dot min. The maximum price would be final price dot max. If we don't have any NAV data, then in that case, we are writing that there's no historical data available. So let me just save it and come back to the dashboard. I'll run the dashboard. It is taking some time for the Monte Carlo simulation. Perfect, we have got the results. So these are the line charts of the simulation that we are doing using the average return and the standard deviation of Nippon small cap growth plan, right? The projected NAV is ranging between these two numbers, and we are doing it for 252 days, which we can of course change using this particular slider. In the end, we are making a summary. The expected NAV is 12.43. The minimum it can go in next 252 days is 6.97. The maximum it can go is 21.12 NAV price. So yes, this is the very user-friendly dashboard that we have created. If we change the number of simulations and the number of projected days, it will update the results accordingly. Now we have a different plot and the different expected final NAV, the minimum price and the maximum price of Nippon India Small Cap Fund. Guys, if you are finding any difficulty in writing this particular code, it's absolutely fine. I will be saving this code in my Google Drive. All my Google Drive community members can directly just copy and paste it from the Google Drive. If you don't know about it, guys, you can become a Google Drive community member by just following some few steps. Just go to my YouTube channel, click on this particular link, which is on the right side of my profile picture. It will redirect to this YouTube community post. Just follow these steps to become a Google Drive community member. I charge a very small amount of money. Again, I have hired a couple of interns to maintain the quality of the content over there as good as possible. So yes, that's absolutely worth it. Please explore the community. And not only this code, there are many more codes which are available on my Google Drive, like my personal trading bot, my Pinescript strategies, etc., etc. So it's completely worth spending a few pennies on my Google Drive. Last but not the least, guys, if you liked even one thing about this video, please click on the like button. It really helps with the algorithm. And also click on the subscribe button and hit on the bell icon, because there are many more videos which are about to come on this YouTube channel. And I don't want you guys to miss on any content that I put on my YouTube channel. For freelancing inquiries, please reach out to us at this email address, and one of my team members will respond as soon as possible. Thank you so much, guys, for watching this video till the end. You can click here to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Over there, you'll see this entire playlist on mutual fund analysis. And over there, you'll see how I created a MT5 trading bot in less than 1 hour. Keep learning, keep finding financial programming, and I'll see you very, very soon in the next video. Until then, peace.